You know, Rick is really busy. He's an unusual person. in that he's probably as busy as me, and I've got a work ethic. I think that's one of the things I have. I've got no talent. I don't think I've ever had natural talent at martial arts, but what I have is a willingness to work 30 hours a week. You know, and if you've got a willingness to work 30 hours a week, you don't need talent. You know? I mean, it'd be awesome to have that. And the work ethic, but I've never had the talent. I've just worked hard. And Rick does the same. You know, in his own world, his work is very similar. So we kind of live parallel lives, really, in a way. Rick, you know, with his Wing Chun focus, and me with my BJJ focus. But our lives have been very similar in that we're putting in there, we're going, we're doing the work, and we're really into it. And we love it. We're driven by the passion. So it's been a real pleasure. So Rick is a little unusual in that he hasn't kind of, you know, we don't see him in the scene so much. He's not out there, you know, in the competition scene and doing all this thing. But that's he's got a reason for that, and that's because he's got his focus here with you guys. So it's great for him. But this is the one thing I'll say for Rick is what my coach said to me, and it is a truth. It's not just a thing that comes out of people's mouths, although it is said a lot. And that's the start of your BJJ journey. Now, I remember when my coach said to me those words, this is the start of your BJJ journey, when I got my black belt. I remember thinking, yeah, you're like, you're saying that, but come on, I know some BJJ. And he was exactly right. I can tell you without a shadow of a doubt, I've learned, I would say, more than 80% of the stuff I know now, I learned post black belt. Because after I had my black belt, I had enough language in my head. You know, I understood the art enough that when I saw something or did something, I would have a different view of it than when I was a white belt. So my coach said to me, we're going to start again. See you Monday. Well, I thought it was just like, what's it, rhetorical? Rhetorical. You know, he said, we'll start again Monday anyways. It's not even a question. But is he a rhetorical statement? Can you do that?
No.
Is that right? Seems all right. We'll go with it. Come Monday, he said, okay, I turned up, and I thought, now we're going to learn something new and something funny, cool. And he goes, produce that, Upa. Upa? I know Upa. I've been doing Upa for 10 years. He goes, you don't know Upa. Like, you think you know. You know what I'm talking about. Yeah, you trap the arm, you trap the foot, you bridge it off. He goes, idiot. And then he showed me, and I went, oh my God, I've never seen it like that. And he goes, yeah, that's right, you haven't, because you've been an idiot for 10 years. Now you're less of an idiot, I can teach you. And we started again, and he made me make a list of 200, I think it was about 200 moves. Like, he said, what are the most 200 and most important, like, you have to have to be done. So I went away, and I compiled a list of a couple of moves. And over the next 4 or 5 years, that's what we did, we worked through it. Scissor sweep, but black belt scissor sweep. Black belt hooper, wow. You know, and my brain changed, like, radically. So now I can do it myself, because after doing that exercise with him, for a while, I can do something now that I haven't done for 3 or 4 years, and as I'm doing it, I can look at it and really get what I'm doing and make improvements. So it was kind of like a, you know what I'm saying? So that happened to me, and I'm sure it will happen to you.
It was a humbling thing to take your belt off and suddenly throw yourself in amongst a discipline that we were completely unaware of. And then get smashed by guys that had done 10 hours more jiu-jitsu than you, regardless of how much more experience you think you had than them. I often joke about this, what most people don't realise is I would go over to Anthony's and do a class at 10:30 on a Friday morning, scoot back over as quick as I could to get the 12:15 lunchtime class on Friday, teach that class, then teach it again on Sunday, then teach it the following Tuesday, so we'd have 3 or 4 shots out. Everyone was going like, mate, you're a genius, this is brilliant. And I used to joke with only probably Andrew, I said, I'm only an hour in front. But an hour makes a huge difference. It's the best thing we've ever done.